Kubor nagashlem jong unong san hima.
Unong yalam kaliang persya Dr. Mukul Sangma ula aiksai. Bakalaban jia ke AKA kesan hima si maha po ke National People's Party. Bat ula kubur. Baka jing sya arong ki MLA ki badai ni kawai ke seng sya kawai pat. Kadai ke AKA ke jing tenjo ke baju jia. Bat ke long ke bae bha ban te lakam. Dr. Mukul ubadai ru unong yalam ke TMC hamikhalia ula penpau ya kani. Apa jubab ya kejingkeli la ke TMC kepadan sanggut ki MLA ke matne em ya kejing tunjuk kumbakala jia ya ke kongres kepala dukno laingut ki MLA ke balai ban penyeso bat ke NPP dangha ke khat khandai tarik unai lar arajar arpusau laingut ki MLA ke kongres Dr. Celestine Lingdo Gabriel Waklang barba Charles Marngar kila ino ya ke kongres ke seng ke bakila yo jingjob Okay, election MLA arajar arpulai, but kilalit man long kawaino, but ke NPP. Dr. Mukul loong, bakam long kebasuk ban long kibas kem bat ban la ban yeng haka san hima sima, namar lada piklan mapi bat kakin hon, kin persyang bon kibut, kumno ban pentelot yepi dagabatan yano yano ubahajan e jongpi. Dr. Mukul bolong noyalam ke TMC baru MLA ubara rimtam. Cong ke ying dar bathawan ke jela ula kedau. Bagi jingjia ke bajia ha kesanyi hima. Ha ke baka NPP ke badan arpu nrengut ke MLA hausnya marajar arpu lai. Kala syukew kensan syaka arpu perangut. Ban menta kala don lai pu wengut. Ki jing tok ha ki kenrok ki pausena kumnu ke NPP ke babat. Jika jing syar ke pun poy haduk lai pu wengut ke MLA. Kini kapan iya baka deka jingle kapa longkut lat lani desperate haka ketin pareng. Namar ka don ka ee deka ee hapo la benrap u Dr. Mukul.
It, look at the mandate of the people. You know, the mandate is a fractured mandate. Irrespective of what happened subsequent to the actual outcome of the last election. So in a situation where you have a fractured mandate, even which constitute the opposition, you have three groups there, TMC, Congress, VPP. Now, since the mandate has been for us to be in the opposition, I think we should look at our responsibilities vested upon us as per the mandate of the people. And therefore, it is only natural that we all come together and articulate things in the right perspective, somehow see that we align our resolve and strength and respond to the call of duty in the right ways. It is important to really aggregate and align ourselves as opposition, because otherwise also when you put you take all the numbers, the total, the cumulative strength of the opposition is just 10. Now you also are aware of the fact that there are a number of provisions in the rules of your rules of procedure and conduct of business in the Meghalaya Legislative Assembly vis-a-vis the constitutional provision, where unless the opposition come together, there are a number of issues under the relevant provisions of the rules of procedure and conduct of business which cannot be taken up unless we come together. So the importance of understanding of being cohesive as opposition is crucial while we keep the interests of the people in the state above everything else.
The question is,
as I have said, the opposition must always come together in order to aggregate our strength in our system of democracy. When we take up issues, numbers also become crucial. As I have said, when certain issues are taken up under relevant provision of the rules of procedure and conduct of business, what happens is that such and such number must stand up. You know, there are so many things. Therefore, it is necessary for us to understand how we must aggregate our strength in respect of the numbers. That's why coming together, since the mandate has been fractured, we have different groups belonging to different identities in as far as the opposition as well as the ruling is concerned. So what is the most important priority before us? The priority is the issues confronting the people and the state as well. Therefore, we have to put that as priority, and nothing else must supersede the interests of the people and interests of the state. That's how the democracy operates. That's how we tend to generate that kind of positive perception about our given system of democracy and governance.
Well,
for any political party, for that matter, it is easier said than done that a political party will be wiped out from a state. It doesn't happen. It doesn't happen. Because it is ultimately the people who will watch, judge, and ultimately decide and give the mandate. So therefore, under the given situation, it may be just the other way around, you know? And writing is on the wall. Writing is on the wall. You see, the NPP is in the government. The present dispensation of government, the ruling dispensation, is led by NPP. They had 26. They become 28. Then now they become 31. How they managed to come up to 28 and 31, we all know. And it can be also interpreted as a desperate move of the party, keeping in mind the undercurrent which threatened their, the very stability of the present dispensation, the present ruling dispensation. I'm telling it because I know what is happening within NPP. Okay, so it is not it will not be appropriate for me to say that any of the political parties or agree to that kind of comment that any of the political parties will be wiped off. You know, it doesn't happen so easily. But I am sure that people are the best judge, and NPP will be confronted by much more complicated challenges in as far as the electoral battle in the days ahead are concerned. Yeah. A simple question, but a difficult answer. You know, because in politics we don't put the cards on the table, and you know it, and I know it. So you'll not get an answer on that. Earlier they had scab government. Now they don't have scab government. You can interpret, read between the lines of what I have said, and interpret. Okay. Therefore, the actions reflect their intent, you know. Therefore, if you are looking at the outcome of the action, that itself will have your answers. Today, in the last 1.5 years, if you go from the day one till today, you will be probably seeing, all the instances of irregularity, all the instances of denial of the government to really agree to identify the problem. Now, what happens when we discuss about problem? Now, the problem may revolve around instances of irregularities. Problem may be something which revolves around the perception of the people pertaining to certain instances which is interpreted as alleged act of corruption, nepotism, favoritism, etc. Now, if there is a sincere and honest intent to resolve issues and ensure that nothing which is considered as detrimental to the interests of the people and the state should be allowed to happen under the present dispensation and under the watch and control of the present dispensation of government, then they should actually demonstrate that they have the sincere desire to identify the problem. Forget about identifying the problem. Somehow you will be able to understand that they don't even want to listen to the problem. Even before they agree to say, yes, there is a problem. Therefore, unless you identify a problem, there cannot be a solution. And this failure to identify may be intentional or unintentional. By default, the incompetence. But I don't doubt their competence. Therefore, I'll have reasons to believe that it has become become their strategy, rather the modus operandi, which they have scripted so well that they allow things to happen and they continue to be on denial mode. There are, see, one thing is that look at how with so much of confidence and with sense of impunity, allegations of corruptions are being thrown out at towards the government. The allegation directed towards corruption, engagement of nepotism, favoritism by many, not just one, but the recent instant case is the allegation which is directed towards the government about various other illegal ways and means of making money which they are using. That is the allegation. Now, that's why I have said that the government must come out clean. They have to prove that, well, the allegations are false. In absence of that, or rather, failure to prove that the allegations are false, that means it is a proof in itself that we have to believe that the allegations are true. So the onus of responsibility to come out clean lies with the government and the leadership thereof. These word of exchange of these words and allegations and counter-allegations or whatever you call them or however you refer to their conversation is between the Congress president and the MPP, not between us. I am asking them, if there has been allegation, they have to prove that the allegations are false. Doesn't he understand what I mean? They have to prove that the allegations coming from the president of the Pradesh Congress Committee, the ex-MP, Sri Vincent H. Pala, is wrong. They have to prove that. Or they have to take head on to confront him and to prove themselves that they are not. Yes, that's what is how the interpretation of law will be. So I don't get trapped by this rhetoric. It is their responsibility to prove that the allegations coming from none other than the president of Pradesh Congress Committee, State Pradesh Congress Committee, is false. That's their job. You know, we have a system of self-governance. We also have the customary laws and traditional practices, which is part and parcel of our traditional customs and practices, and which has withstood the test of time. If there is an allegation in the village level, then if the allegations are false, then the one who throws such false allegation is required to attend the court of our local traditional courts. That's how the law operates. You understand? So similar law, the principle of law is same, not only in respect of our traditional laws. So he has to understand the magnitude of this allegation. Is it not a serious allegation? It is necessary for Government of India to take cognizance of this allegation. You know why? You know why? Because the issue of illegal coal mining. Coal mining is not a state subject. Okay? Therefore, Government of India also must take cognizance. Any violation of law under the Section 21 of MMDR Act 1957 is cognizable offense. So cognizable offense means cognizable offense. Who is going to act upon this mandate of law and be honest to their responsibilities vis-a-vis the implementation of the enforcement of the law? So therefore, these things are not something which should be just taken as the rhetoric coming out only for political reasons. No, we take it seriously. Are in astronomical figures, you know, not just 1 crore, 2 crore, 5 lakh, 10 lakhs, 100 crore, 200 crore, 400 crore. That means a big cartel is operating on these. And if such big cartels are operating in Northeast, it is not, this criminality is not confined in Northeast. Therefore, Government of India had to take cognizance of this huge allegation. It cannot be just an allegation and then the one who comes with allegations keeps quiet. If he has come up with an allegation, he also should proceed further. I am only asking them to be responsible. I am asking both the parties to be responsible. And that is my job. And if they are not responsible, I have to write to Prime Minister. I have to write to Prime Minister that these are the allegations, please take cognizance and take action. Yes, I'll wait and see. If they don't do, then that is the ultimate course of action, which will be something considered as my responsibility.